The Aston Martin Lagonda was the pinnacle of luxury. When it debuted in 1976, it was one of the most expensive and probably the most technologically advanced cars in the world for its time. But it wasn't built in some futuristic factory. It was made by hand in a shed. Aston Martin had been riding high in the 50s and 60s. It won Le Mans and it built the Bond car. But things soured in the 70s as the oil crisis wiped out the market for big, thirsty cars, just what Aston Martin made. A few years into the decade, the sweet little British car company was already going out of business. It stopped selling cars in America, it went bankrupt, it closed its factory. But a new owner stepped in, reopened the factory, and wanted a bold new design to herald Aston's comeback. That was the Lagonda, priced at almost £50,000, equivalent today to about £197,000, or $244,000. To justify the price, it had 305 horsepower, plush leather seats, and wood trim on the inside. The Lagonda also had a groundbreaking digital dashboard, the first of its kind, and who wouldn't be sold on exclusivity like that? But here's the thing. This ultra-luxurious, highly desired Aston Martin was built in what looked more like a shed than a factory. The whole car was machined, formed, and assembled by hand. No robots, no nothing. The panels were hammered out on wooden bucks. More fascinating still was the CRT-based dashboard. CRT, short for cathode ray tube, are what TVs were before there were flat screens. These were rarely used in cars, and to have three of them? Well, that was unheard of. The computer that drove these three screens was cutting edge, but at the same time was allegedly designed by a local kid, and as a result, was almost impossible to keep running or repair. If, however, it stayed on long enough for the driver to show off, well, that was almost worth the £50,000 right there. It's pretty clear that in almost every way, Aston Martin was reaching beyond their abilities with the Lagonda. And while it sucks if you were one of the few people to actually own one at the time, for the rest of us, it's kind of fantastic. Aston Martin gave the world a razor-sharp, wedge-shaped marvel for everyone else to look at with a combination of wonder and bafflement. And in the end, that's worth it.
Big V8s and Aston Martin Lagonda is not the only maker's name on the cam covers. Every engine has its own builder's name here, too.